Good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. In the previous class, you all have learned about some of the options of the standard toolbar and their usage, and also learned about some options of the file menu. As you all know, this is your practice class and you will be revising what you learned in the previous class. So before getting on with the class, let us ask ourselves some questions. Do you know why the table option is used? Using the table option, you can compile or put together any of your data. It could be a list of students, the results of the students, some office work data, etc. Can you tell why is the find and replace option used? As you all know, using the find option, you can look for or search for a word in your page. To perform the find function, you need to type in the word that you want to find in the find box. Then, using the replace option, you can replace the word you have found with a word of your choice. Can you tell what happens with the use of the navigator? Using the navigator, you can get information about your active page, and while on the writer page, you can get information about the active contents. If you have inserted a picture, then you can get to know the number of such pictures. Similarly, if you have inserted a table, you can get the count of such tables that you have inserted. Can you tell how can you remove the non-printing characters? To remove the non-printing characters, you need to click on the non-printing option in the standard toolbar. This will remove the non-printing characters. Do you know what you need to do to be able to see your document in a web page? To be able to see your document in the web page, you will need to click on the option for preview in web browser of the file menu. Now, switch on your computer and open the writer file. Let us see what you will learn in today's class. In today's class, you will practice what you have learned in the previous class. Can you tell what is a table? A table is made up of many rows and columns. The horizontally drawn lines make the rows and the vertically drawn lines make the columns. Now you all go ahead and show how you will draw a table. In the table, include school name, total number of students, total number of girls, total number of boys, number of classes, etc. If you like, you can also show the results of the school. If you face a problem in doing this, then you can do the same after watching this video. By watching this video, let us now see how we can create a table using the option in the standard toolbar on our writer page. So to do this, bring your pointer to the table option in the standard toolbar, click there, and a box opens for insert table. You can change the number of columns and the number of rows. You can increase them or decrease them as per your requirement. So we are keeping 5 columns and 5 rows. Click on OK and a table gets inserted on your writer page. Now let's write the title in the first row for each of these columns. So we can write name of the student, because we are preparing a student record. Next, we write the class as the title. In the third cell, of the first row, we type the roll number as is being shown in this video here to you. So this is how we are creating a table. In the next cell, let's type total, total marks or total number. And based on the total marks obtained or total number, we can give a pass or fail remark in the last column. Pass or fail, depending on the condition that we have set. And let's type in the names column. We can type names. We can type whatever name you like, or you can simply type ABC. As is being shown in the video, we are typing ABCD as the names of the students. Next, we type the class of the student. We are typing 10th as the class for all these four students. Watch the video and you can also create a table like this and also key in all the data about the students. So this is how you will be keeping records of the students. In the next column, roll number, we can type a roll number. Here we are simply using 1, 2, 3 and 4 for the four students. Total number or the total marks obtained is the next column. So for student A who has roll number 1, we have typed 78 marks, then 56, C has 30. So here, except for the student C who has only got 30 marks, all other students are pass, only student C is fail. So this is how you can create a table and maintain records of the students or any other records that you want to maintain on your writer sheet. Now show how you will practice with find and replace. Replace the names appearing in the table with the help of the find and replace option. If you have a doubt, watch the video. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use the find and replace option of the standard toolbar in our table on the writer page. For this, we need to take our cursor to the find and replace option. Click there in the standard toolbar. A box opens and you can type the text or whatever you want to search for or find in your writer page. For instance, if we had made a mistake in keying in the marks of student C as 30, let's try to find where 30 is. We type 30 in the search for box and click on find. Click on yes and OK. And you can see that the marks, 30 marks, are selected or highlighted and it has been found. Now if we want to replace these 30 marks with the correct marks, we again have to take a pointer to the find and replace option. Click there and now first type in the search for box what figure you want to replace. So 30 is already written and we want to replace with the correct marks of the student C, which are 70. So we type 70, click on the replace button as is being shown in the video. Click on yes here and OK. And you can see that instead of 30, the marks 70 have come there. So 30 has been replaced by 70. You can close this. If we want to use find and replace, remember we had given a remark of fail, so we want to change that. So we want to now find, click on find option. In the search for box, you can type fail, because instead of fail, we want to replace it with pass. So we type fail, click on find, and you can see by moving this box that the fail has got highlighted, the first time where fail is visible. Now you want to replace this with pass. So we type the word pass in this option, in this box, replace with, and click on the replace button. You can say yes here and click on OK. You can close this. You don't want to replace the fail in the title bar. So this is how you can use the find and replace option. Now go ahead and show how you will insert an object. Then show how you will cut the same, and then show how you will paste the same in a different place. Watch the video in case of any doubts. Let us now see this video and learn or practice the use of the gallery option, and even use the gallery option to cut and paste on our writer page. So for using the gallery option, we need to take our pointer or the cursor to the gallery option of the standard toolbar, click on it, and you can see that the gallery option opens, and on the right side you can see many different arrows, and on the left side you can see many different themes are available. You can look for symbols, sounds, symbols for schools and universities, rulers, people, and so on. You can scroll up and down to see different symbols available for different themes. For instance, here we have clicked on the diagram theme, and from here again if we scroll up and down, we can see that even within the diagram there are many diagrams available to choose from. So we can pick the one which we like, click on that to select that, and then right click so that we can work with it, and you can click on the insert option. If you click on copy, this diagram gets copied at the current location of the cursor. If you click on background, it gets applied on the page or the paragraph wherever you want it. Once you have it on your page, like in this case it has been inserted on the table in the rows, now you can resize it. You can increase or decrease the width, you can increase or decrease the height, and you can also cut it by left right clicking on it and choosing cut. Once again click on the insert option. This time we have clicked on copy, and this object has come on your page. Again, you can resize it, you can drag it and keep it where you want, and if you right click on it, you can choose the cut option to cut it or to delete it from your page. Once again we use insert. This time we are going to background. In background you can choose page, paragraph, table, table row, table cell. So these are the various options. Since we chose page, you can see that this object has been pasted or copied on the entire page. So if you scroll up and down, you can see the object has been pasted on the entire page. So this what we had done was we'd gone to insert, gone to background. And if we want to now put it on table, let us first remove it from the page which was already there. So we can either use undo or cut as the option. Once again, we go to insert, background, and this time we choose table. So when we click here, you see that the object gets inserted or shown on the table itself. You can copy one more time if you like on the page also and move it around, or you can select it and cut it. Now let's see what we can do after we hide the gallery. Let's go to the file option and open a new text document or a new page, and here we can just do a paste because we had cut an object from the previous page. So we can just do a paste by clicking here on the paste option, and you will see that the object appears on our new text document also. So this way you can use the gallery option to get any symbols and also use cut and paste. Now show how can you get non-printing characters. Again, watch the video for any help you need. In this video, we are going to see how we can use the non-printing character option from the standard toolbar. If you click on the non-printing character option in the standard toolbar, you will see that on your table, the non-printing character gets inserted. As is being shown in the video. Now, if you take the cursor and press the space bar or the enter key, you will see more non-printing characters getting inserted. We are pressing enter key or we are pressing the space bar and additional non-printing character are being inserted on our page. If you want to remove these, you will once again have to take the cursor to the non-printing character option and click there. You can see the characters get hidden. If you take the cursor to the table and press it in any cell and enter spaces or enter or use the enter button, you don't see any non-printing characters being shown. However, new spaces and the enter button has been used. So now when you go back and click on the non-printing character option, these additional spaces and use of enter key will show up as non-printing characters. This is how you can make use of the non-printing character option. Next, practice the use of the zoom option. Show how can you zoom the size of the page to 400% and then show how can you bring it down to 50%. Finally, bring the page back to its normal size. In case of a problem, watch the video. With the help of this video now, we are going to practice the use of the zoom option in the standard toolbar. To make use of the zoom option, we need to take our pointer or the cursor to the zoom option in the standard toolbar, click there, box opens, and since we want to make it 400%, we can click on the variable option and use the up arrow to increase the size to 400%. You can keep the mouse or the touchpad button pressed on the up arrow and get the required size of 400%. Note that you can also type in the number 400 in this window, in this box. So once we get to 400, we then go to the OK button and click there, and you will see that the writer page has now zoomed up to 400%. You can use the scroll bar on the bottom and on the right side to see various parts of the writer page, scrolling up and down and scrolling left and right, since it is 400% now. So all that was written here, or all that was drawn here, including the objects and the text, have become 400%. Now if we want to make this 50%, we again click on the zoom option, go to variable, and let's now just type 5050 and then click on OK. And you will see that the page size changes to 50%. This is how you can use the zoom option to zoom in or zoom out. Now, if you want to bring this page to the normal size, you can use the zoom option. Click there and then choose the 100% option. From this box, we can just click on the 100% option, click on OK, and your page returns to its normal size. This is how you will use the zoom option. Now, all of you practice the use of the send option. Use the send option to send a PDF file. If you have any doubt, watch the video. Let us now watch this video and practice the use of the send option. Because we want to send this as PDF, we will take our cursor to the file option, select the send submenu, or click on that option, and from there, because we want to use email as PDF, we will click on the email as PDF option. This will convert our file to PDF. When we click on send from the box that is opened, we click on send. Note that you can only send your document if you have an Outlook account. So your Outlook account page will open. Here in the place where 2 is written, you have to type the email ID of the person to whom you are wanting to send this document. As is being shown in the video, so we have typed the email ID bharatkumar@computershiksha.org, and then we click on the send option to send this document as PDF. Next, all of you go ahead and practice the use of templates, and in case of any problems, watch the video. With the help of this video, let us now practice creating templates, saving them and using them. So in order to create a template, we first need to take our cursor or pointer to the file menu, click on it, and then click on the templates option. From the box that opens, click on the save option. The box opens and you can give a new name for your new template. As is being shown in the video, we type computer Shiksha and then save that. Once again, go to the file menu, click on templates, and this time choose the organize option. Click on My Templates. Look for the template name that you had given, Computer Shiksha. Click on that. Another box opens and you can do Export Template from here. When the address box opens, you can see your file name, Computer Shiksha, written there. Click on the Save button to save this template. And close this template management box. You can close this file and look for the template which you have stored on the desktop, which is here as is being shown in the video. If you double click on it, it opens and you can see your template available to you. So this is how you will use the templates option. Now show how will you get your page in a web page. And in case of any difficulty, learn from the video. Let us now see how we can view our page in web browser. For doing this, take the cursor or your pointer to the file menu in the menu bar, click on that and click on Preview in Web Browser option. As soon as you click there, you will see that the web browser page is opening and your page is being previewed by you in the web browser. This is how you can use the preview in web browser. When you don't want to use it any longer, you can just close this page and come back to your original file. Practice the use of the printer settings option. If you encounter a problem, watch the video and learn from it. With the help of this video, we will just practice or review the use of the printer setting options. To use the printer setting options, you will take your cursor or the pointer to the file menu in the menu bar, click on that and then choose the printer settings option. A box opens for printer setup. First, you can choose from any of the printers that may be connected to your computer which printer you want to use. Then click on Properties and a box opens wherein you have the advanced options by which you can change paper output, or you can make changes to the graphics management. You can choose from different documents options. Then if you go to printing shortcuts, you can change the print quality, normal, fast draft, fast normal, any of these you can choose. You can change the paper type that you want to use. Also look for paper sizes, letter, legal, A4, any of these you could choose. You can choose the or change the orientation of the printout. And you can select to print on both sides of the paper. Next option is of the paper quality. Here you can have more options of the paper quality. It gives you the size, you can choose the letter or draft, and within this you can choose different sizes of the paper that you want the printout to come on. You can scroll up and down. You can see the sizes by metric system or in English names by the English name. Once you have chosen, you can click on OK. Right now we are just closing the box. You can change the print quality. Fast draft, fast normal. Next option is for the effects. With this you can either opt for the actual size to be printed or you can look for printing the document on different, like a letter, and you can choose the sizes from this drop down window as is being shown in this video. You can zoom the print by sliding on this slide bar. So you can zoom in or zoom out, and you can see the effect of this in the preview window. You can also apply a watermark on your printouts by choosing the watermark from here. Next option is for finishing. So you can choose the finishing. For instance, you can have 2 pages per sheet, 4 pages per sheet, and so on. So you can choose that. In the color option, you can either opt for colors to be applied, or you can print in grayscale and use options like high quality or normal quality. So once you have made the changes, you can save those changes. Right now we just close this box. Besides the properties, in the printer setup you also see some options. You can click on the options and look for different contents, pictures and objects, form controls, page background. These are different contents you can select. Different types of pages, left pages, right pages, you can select that, select comments. Once you make the changes, in the other option you also have print automatically from on the inserted paper or print from the tray, pick up the paper from the tray. So once you have chosen these options, you can click on OK to apply these changes. If you want a fax, you can also select the fax option and then click on OK. We are just going to close this window and close this one also. This is how you can use the printer setup option on your writer page. Since this class ends here, close your file and properly shut down your computers. You practiced what you had learned previously in today's class. You also got to practice the use of some of the leftover options of the standard toolbar, like table, find and replace, navigator, zoom, etc., and also use some options of the file menu like send, templates, preview in web browser and printer settings. Computer Shiksha is supported by, thank you.